In August, guided missile destroyer USS Zumwalt arrived in Mississippi to begin a two-year process to install hypersonic missile tubes. A statement from the Navy provided to USNI News stated, USS Zumwalt, DDG 1000, arrived in Pascagoula, Mississippi today to enter a modernization period and receive technology upgrades, including the integration of the conventional prompt strike weapon system. The upgrades will ensure Zumwalt remains one of the most technologically advanced and lethal ships in the U.S. Navy. Ingalls President Kari Wilkinson said in a statement, "To the crew and families of the guided missile destroyer USS Zumwalt, we would like to extend the warmest welcome to the newest members of our shipyard community. It is an honor for us to serve you and the Navy by doing this important work." This is a significant development. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Zumwalt-class warships are getting armed with hypersonic missile. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. A 256-bit encryption keeps your online data safe, even on public Wi-Fi, and its threat protection system helps shield against malware and cyber threat. NordVPN application is available for Windows, macOS, iOS, Android, Linux, and even Android TV, and also encrypted proxy extensions for Chrome, Firefox, and Edge. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The Zumwalt-class destroyers have 80 Mark 57 cells protected by the Peripheral Vertical Launch System, PVLS, as well as two 155mm guns. Each Mark 57 can carry a single SM-2 or SM-6 long-range surface-to-air missile, ASROC anti-submarine rocket torpedo, or up to 4 evolved Sea Sparrow short-range surface-to-air missiles. Importantly, they can also carry Tomahawks. The two 155mm advanced gun systems were supposed to be capable of engaging targets with precision-guided shells at ranges of up to 60 miles, or 95 kilometers. The long-range land attack projectile, or LRLAP, the precision-guided shell that would arm the ship's guns, saw cost escalation from $50,000 a round to $800,000. The U.S. Navy, for this reason, canceled LRLAP. The U.S. Navy has decided to rearm the class and shift the focus of Zumwalt from close to shore to blue water engagement with the installation of hypersonic weapons. The gun system will be replaced to add hypersonic weapon. As per reports, the U.S. Navy has determined that the hull can accommodate 4 87-inch missile tubes. Each of these tubes would be able to house 3 common hypersonic glide bodies, CHGB, along with their boosters. That means Zumwalt will be armed with a total of 12 missiles. The U.S. Department of Defense has been developing the CHGB so that it will serve as the base of its offensive hypersonic missile. CHGB will be used by the different services of the U.S. military, Army, and Navy. U.S. Navy was put in charge of developing the CHGB. The design of the common hypersonic glide body is based on the previously developed alternate re-entry system, which was tested in the early 2010s as part of the Army's Advanced Hypersonic Weapon Program. The alternate re-entry system was itself based on the Sandia Winged Energetic Re-entry Vehicle Experiment (SWERV) prototype developed by Sandia National Laboratories in the 1980s. CHGB's dimensions are common across the Navy and Army and have been developed keeping in mind many aspects. Wolf said, you need to have the same lethality no matter where you're at, and that's what this weapon does. It's all the same with the lethality to get after these targets. It just depends on who's launching it, right? Whether it's the Army from a transporter erector launcher, or whether it's a Zumwalt, or whether it's a Virginia-class submarine. In the CHGB approach, the glider will be launched to extremely high altitudes using a ballistic missile, then separate from the carrier missile, and will skim back to the Earth towards its intended target, attaining hypersonic speed. Hypersonic speed means the object exceeds Mach 5. That's 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. Each service of the U.S. military will use the CHGB as the base while developing individual weapon systems, such as launchers capable of firing weapons from land or sea. The CHGB will have a warhead, guidance system, as well as thermal protection shield. Dianetics will build the glide vehicle, while Lockheed Martin will build the booster, as well as assemble the missile and launch equipment. The CHGB will also be able to maneuver in flight, unlike traditional ballistic missiles, and is much faster than a typical cruise missile. The combination of high speed and the ability to take an unpredictable path will make the missile a lethal weapon. There's no dependable way to intercept this kind of weapon at present. CHGB is being seen as providing an alternative to nuclear weapons for strategic retaliatory strikes. The U.S. Navy wants the weapons installed and the destroyer ready to be deployed by 2025. Vice Admiral Johnny Wolf, the head of the Navy's strategic systems programs, told reporters at the Naval Submarine League's annual symposium in November, "We are talking about deploying the system on DDG 1000 in 2025. That's 3 years from now." However, in June, the Government Accountability Office cast doubt on whether the weapons would be prepared in time. The report reads, "The CPS Program Office noted that significant scope and challenges associated with the first-time integration of CPS may present risks to achieving DDG 1000's installation schedule. In reviewing CPS Program Office information on critical technologies, we found that significant work remains for the program to demonstrate technology maturity." It adds, "If the hypersonic weapon is not ready for integration on the DDG 1000 at the time of the aforementioned maintenance period, the Navy may have to extend the duration of the planned maintenance period or wait for the next scheduled period to incorporate the system on the ship. It remains to be seen how things pan out in the coming days."
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.